Hello everyone. Today I will show you one of the my creative ideas in from the Samslav openings, which I played in European Team Championship against Kinderman. We played d4 c4 d5 c4 6 is Slav take c4. I play a4 bishop f5 knight e5 knight d7 knight c4 knight b6 knight a5. And here is my opponent play a5 move. I remember it's 10 years ago, or maybe little bit more, 10 or maybe 8, 10, 12 years ago. Many Chinese chess players like to play a5 move. It's like Wang Yu, is Bu Hianzhi, is many players is like to play a5 move. And after a5 is, of course, is three moves is very good, is very popular here. One of the, of course, to play just e3 moves, very solid move. Also, f3 move to preparing to play e4 is also very solid moves, very good. And one g3 is Chinese players is like to play g3 move with white. But when my opponent play a5, I just start to think how to surprise for my opponent. And of course, it is not easy to okay. You can to think how to play here for surprise bishop g5, or if you now move e3, f3, g3. You play these moves, it will be not surprise for your opponents. And your opponent, if he played a5 move, he's absolutely sure his black is okay. Really, it's not easy to play with white in this position if your opponent know how to play. And I start to think about 10 minutes here in move 8. But for me, it's absolutely different because I every time like to play immediately. And in the openings and to just to go to middle games and to start in to think in middle games. But here I start to think and I look one interesting idea. Why not to play everyone play e3 f3 to just e3 is you want to play g4. Yeah, every time you play f3 your idea is somewhere to play g4. But why not start to rook g1? When I play this move, of course it's my team players is it was they was not very happy when they see his move rook g1 because his rook g1 looks very strange because after rook g1 you lose all your chance to go castle, only chance to long castle, but in bishop in e5 and it's not easy. But rook g1, but after this move I play rook g1 a few times, minimum 5 10 times. I play after Kinderman. I play after 1 year after this game. I played against Huzman, who was helping for Gelfand in match everyone, and he was also big surprised when I played rook g1, and he also played not good here, and I got to winning position in move 14 or 15. Everyone when I play rook g1, everyone tried to play against me g6 move. This is looks absolutely normal move because you play rook g1 and you open it to play g6. Why they like to play g6? Because after g4, okay, it looks bishop b6. Yeah, it's rook in g1 absolutely strange. No castle and pawn in g6 looks safe. Bishop g7 castle. But Husman and also his Kinderman play g6 and I play just e4, knight d7, and I just take. But also here's I offer to play next time if you have chance to play knight f3 is you can save knights because knight f3 and next move knight g5. After knight d7 I take. It's also I think it's best to take d7, but the second knight f3, bishop d7, just bishop b3, and bishop g7, and I play queen b3. Here is also a very good idea to play f4 move. Look these pawns, it's like 5 pawns in a row. Yeah, it's very super pawns, and as black is absolutely big problem in center, and not easy to play with blacks any moves because I can every time attack with pawns and white position is very good. But I played queen b3 castle f4 and here is my opponent played knight c8. It's very good move, but again it's after queen c2 is white is pawns very good and the white is advantage. It's absolutely easy to see to how to play with this pawn. You just do castle. And after maybe is h4 is coming, h5 is white, his pawns is very strong. I think g6 move is bad move, but when you place rook g1, of course, is your opponent is a big surprise for your opponents and not easy to understand how to play here because absolutely new move, new idea. Rook g1, white is not lose to tempo to play e3, g4, and after e3, e4. You play rook g1, g4, e4, f4. Your idea is very interesting, and you immediately show you play for win, you play for attacking chess. And for this reason, I think is rook g1 is one of my best creative move in openings. After rook g1, of course, I analyzed this position many times, and I think I can offer for black to play few moves. One of the moves is looks like e6. You can play e6, is absolutely normal move to continue to play bishop b4, but g4, bishop g6, you can play h4. In the board, it's not too easy to play with black because now you want to play h5, and bishop b4, h5, bishop e4. It's not easy to understand after f3. Is black is very good move, knight fd5. You need to calculate this move, but every time not easy to understand how to play because you need to play f6 move. You need to understand here maybe some bishop c2 moves, tactical move, take, take, queen d4. I mean, with black, you need to analyze and play this position. In the board, it's not easy because pawn is attacking, this looks very dangerous and not easy to play. G4, bishop g6, h4, bishop b4, yes, h5. Here, white can play just e3. His pawn is very good. Now it's g5, f3. And here is black is only move h6. This looks good. But here is bishop d2. White pawns is looks like Karakhan openings. White pawns is very strong. And if you will do some long castle or maybe some f3, king f2, it will be very good pawns in center, and I think this white is advantage here. For good engines, his position is near to equal, but I think it's not easy to play with black. Yeah, I mean here is absolutely very strong move, fantastic move. Black need to play bishop c2, not to give to long castle. I mean it's absolutely not human positions. It's only easy to say when you check in the engines, but for white is rook g1 is looks very good idea. But if play not e6, not g6, g6 I think is bad move, which in 5 games in row, which when I play rook g1, three my opponents play g6, and it's absolutely bad moves. And all grandmaster played g6 move because they think it's very good, very solid move, but it's not solid and not good move. After g6 is just very good advantage for white because center is very good for e4, g4, f4. I think his best move is here h5. Why h5? Because his idea rook g1 to play g4. He only move why rook g1? Because g4. Yeah, but h5 is stop it. If I will play here h3 move to again to try to play g4. There is h4 move, and here is not good to play g4 because take, take, and it's different pawn structures, and also h3 pawn is losing. And for this point, is h5 because move is very good. And after h5, I want to play rook g1, h5, if move f3. As one big minus for black is because if black will do castle, it will be very easy to attack with black king because g4 and immediately open h line, and it will be not easy to play with black. If knight d7, I just play maybe not knight d7, also e6 moves looks good, e4, bishop h7, and just bishop b3. Now is bishop in h7 is very strange, and the pawn in h5 is not good because after g4 it will be easy to attack. But for engine, his black position is not bad because it's absolutely different sync, different looks with engine. but for humans it's not easy to play. I think nobody will be, not one grandmaster will be happy in this position, because look, this castle and long castle, how to play with black, because g4 is coming his next move, and black king will be not good, bishop h7 is very bad, and I think his white positions looks very good here. If not e6, if black will play knight d7, now I play e4, if take knight e5, I just take f5, knight d7 and bishop b3. Next queen b3, long castle, is two bishops here, and the white position is very good. Is maybe it's bishop h7 is another move, and if bishop b3, e6, I can take and queen c2. As white is pawns in center is very good, and after long castle again it will be not easy. If I white will play g4, open g line, and it will be easy to attack with black king, and the white's position is better. And after rook g1, if not play h5 is different move, is just to play h6. Maybe it looks more solid for black, because pawn in h5 is different, in h6 different. Now I can play two different moves, g4 or f3. If f3 is e6, e4, and just to play bishop b3, is white's idea is easy to play, and the white is just play pawn in center, e4, f3, and bishop b3, queen b3, and just long castle. And bishop b4, queen b3, knight d7, just knight d3 back, we attack b4, and not queen e7 is looks not easy, because white can take b4 and play with two bishops. But I think it's better not to take and just g4, and this looks again very interesting position. f5 take, it's absolutely engine lines, which engine think is absolutely equal position, because his knight is not very good, and white is two bishops, but black is one extra pawn, and knight b2, and okay, his position's near to equal. Yeah, but we can play h6, not f3, we can play g4 to bishop h7, g5, it is looks is like a very nice position, very active position for white. And okay, I mean, after g5 it will be not easy to do castle with black, because g line will open, maybe some problems with pawn h2, but it is a normal, we can sacrifice pawn for attack, take knight e4. Here is also possible to take knight e4 or to play not easy move e3, because take rook h5. This looks very strange, rook in h5 in the openings, rook in h5, but it's when is rook in h5, his bishop is no move, and also we can attack maybe bishop d3 next moves, and knight e4, we can take queen b3 to attack in f7 is mate idea. If bishop d5, queen d3 is we try to play e4, knight d7, long castle, bishop b6, just take e4, and the white's center is very good. I think it's very good to play with white, because every time d5, not easy to play with black, because bishop is bad and king in center, and I think here is for me is for white is advantage. And if I will get any chance to play these openings, this move rook g1 again, I will play for sure. Yeah, I think it was a good idea for you all, and you like to play, you like this move rook g1. It's absolutely a new idea, and I think after rook g1 it will be not easy to play with black, and if some grandmasters against me play g6, why not to play this again, and why not play rook g1 again, because it's absolutely creative idea, and very interesting to play for win. I wish you all the best. Thank you very much. Good luck.